Wanna learn web scraping with Python requests? I'm Ivan, a full-stack developer at SmartProxy, and today I'll show you how to extract and parse data using requests HTML library. Okay, so today we're gonna touch on the very basics of scraping with Python. If you're using Python, you probably know it's a good idea to create a virtual environment. For that, I'm using virtualenv. You can use any other tool at your disposal. So let's create one. Virtualenv, let's call it venv, typical. Okay, and now activate. Venv bin activate. And voila, our virtual environment is activated. We will need some libraries. So as I said, we're looking today at requests and request HTML. So let's install requests and requests. HTML. Okay, let's wait. Okay, so now that the libraries have installed, let's import them. So import requests. And also we will need to import the HTML session from the requests HTML library that we've just installed. So from requests HTML, import HTML session. And let's check if I spelled everything correctly. Request HTML. Yes, HTML session. Okay. So firstly, we will need some sort of URL to scrape. I found one good one that is our Smart Proxy blog. And today we're going to try scraping all the headings that we have here on the page. So let's firstly declare a URL that we're going to scrape. So URL. That's going to be HTTPS smartproxy.com blog. Okay. That was a bit of a typo. Okay, so now I'll quickly do the try accept block, which is a good idea because we are working with asynchronous code. Request exception as E. So this will allow us to see any errors if we accidentally have any unexpected errors in our code. Okay, now let's go to the fun part. So in order to start scraping, we need to create an HTML session. The way that request HTML library works is that it creates a session, which then receives the website data, and you can traverse all the necessary HTML tags that you would like to scrape. First of all, let's create the session. HTML session, there we go. Now we need to get a response, and that's where we are started scraping. Session, get, and we'll get the URL. And now, as we wanted to scrape all the headings, let's see what's the actual tag. Let's inspect console. I can see that this is an H3. So we will need to find all the H3s. H3, response, HTML, find, and we'll find H3s. Okay, so now let's see what we have. We'll print H3. And save the file, run the file, and we're getting an array of all the elements that we just scraped from our blog. As you can see, this data itself is not very useful, so let's try to make it a bit more useful. Let's see if we can actually print one of the headings. So because it's an array, we'll pick the first element and we'll look for text. Let's save the file. Let us run the file again. And as you can see, we have successfully scraped our heading here, how to manage multiple accounts on Reddit. Let's go here to the blog and we can see that how to manage multiple accounts on Reddit is indeed the first heading in our blog. So we've successfully scraped the first part. Okay, next, let's try to see all the headings. So for that, we're gonna create a simple for loop. So let's say for heading in H3, and we're gonna print every heading. So heading.txt. Let's save the file, run the file. And as you can see now, we have a list of all the headings that we managed to scrape from our blog. Potentially, this is not really useful for you, although this might be what you wanted, but I would like to save all this in a file. So let us create an array. Let's say results, and that's going to be an empty array to start with. Result equals empty array. Okay, so let's reuse the loop and say that for results, gonna results.append, and we're gonna append a formatted string, and we're gonna put heading.text in that string, and we're gonna make a new line just in case, and that's gonna be results here. Okay, so now that our loop is ready, we will create a results file. We will open the file. Let's call it results.txt. I'm going to write to the file. And then we're going to write lines. So write lines from our results array. Results. Okay. And then results file close, and that should do the trick. Result file. Okay, let's save it, run the code, and we can see that we have a result.txt file with all the headings that we just scraped saved in one file. Success. And that's all you need for basic web scraping with Python HTML requests. Now give it a shot yourself, and don't forget proxies to avoid IP bans. You'll find the code and all the useful links in the video description. Till next time.